Hello all, today we'll be seeing how to prepare sambar rice or sambar sadam. So for that I have taken rice here. I have measured a 3/4 cup of rice and I also have half a cup of toor dal here. So now I will wash these two things and I will soak it in water for half an hour. So I have washed both the rice and the dal and I am soaking it in water. I have added 5 glasses of water to it. Let it soak for half an hour. In the meantime, we will see the other ingredients that are required. I have also taken a small lemon sized tamarind and I am soaking this in hot water. If you have tamarind paste, you can use that also. So for the sambar rice, the vegetables that I have taken are beans, brinjal, small onion, carrot, tomato, potato and drumstick. Other than these, if you have other vegetables, you can add those also. The other vegetables that we can add are green peas, cucumber and like that. So we will wash these vegetables and we will cut it into lengthwise pieces. Like how we cut for avial, no? Like that we will cut them. So now we have cut these vegetables. We will pressure cook these vegetables for 3 whistles. And then we will prepare the masala side by side. So now we will see the items needed for making the masala. So here I have taken 1 tablespoon of chana dal, 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds, 1 teaspoon of urad dal, 1.5 teaspoon of black pepper, and then here I have red chilies, about 6 red chilies. Depending upon the spice level, you can add increase or decrease the red chilies, and 1 teaspoon of saumph, 1 teaspoon of jeera or cumin seed, and I have 1/4 cup of grated coconut. We will just dry roast all these items separately and we will grind these two into a smooth paste. So now we have everything ready. We have the cooked rice and dal, we have the cooked vegetables, we have the grinded masala paste and the tamarind juice is also ready. So we will start bringing everything together. So I have kept a pan here. Now I will add around 2 teaspoons of oil. Then we will add the cooked vegetables. Either you can pressure cook the vegetables or you can just cook it in a pan till the vegetables become soft. Now adding the grinded masala paste. Mix this nicely. And at this stage we will also add the tamarind juice. We will extract the tamarind juice from the soaked tamarind. And we'll add the water. If you are adding tamarind paste at this stage, you can add. Mix it nicely and we'll cook till the raw smell of the tamarind goes off. At this stage we will add salt. So at this stage I will add the cooked rice and the dal. Mix it nicely. Keep it in a medium flame and cook for 5 to 10 minutes.
It should be a little running water consistency, because as it cools down it will become very thick. So if it is thick at the initial stage, you can add little water. So now you will cover and cook this for 5 to 10 minutes. After 5 minutes we will open, we will give it a mix. We will add some coriander leaves, finely chopped, and mix it nicely. Again close and cook it for another 5 minutes.
While it is cooking on the other side, we will fry some cashews. So I am adding ghee to a pan, around 2 teaspoons of ghee. And 2 teaspoons of cashew nuts, broken into pieces. And we will cook them till it turns light golden in color. So it has turned light golden in color. So we will add this to the rice. So in the same pan, now we will add around 1 teaspoon of oil. I'll add few fenugreek seeds. Keep it in a medium flame. Half a teaspoon of mustard seeds. Little bit of hing. And few curry leaves. And 1 red chili. So now we will add this also to the rice. Mix it nicely. Now you can switch off the flame and cover it and let it rest for 5 minutes. So the sambar rice is ready now. You can serve this along with papad. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel for more new recipes. Thank you.